disruptions happening all around us. We're also seeing acceleration in many new technologies. They all promise to transform financial services as we know it, yet significant challenges really lie ahead in terms of the relative adoption of these technologies.
For us, artificial intelligence is really about helping you leverage your data, and it's an extension of advanced analytics. If you look at the paradigm we're seeing is we're going from a person-based ecosystem to a machine-based data ecosystem.
Customers who come to the cloud or people who put data on the cloud need to understand how they can use these controls. So it's sort of both the customers and the enterprises going to the cloud as well as the cloud providers meeting together and trying to come up with this new paradigm.
I think the challenge is to do that in the context of providing the customers what the customer wants, right? So you can't just replace a technology with something else. Yep. You have to find a way to evolve, innovate in that space, understand the proof of concepts, work with clients to see how it works, hopefully influence clients. I think everybody who uses Excel today in financial services, a huge part of that was driven by Reuters and Microsoft working side by side, driving that innovation.
How do you really generate value out of these technologies? Because it's very easy to experiment in labs and just play around with it, because as somebody said, it's a cool thing. But how do you really generate or move the needle for your customers? So you always have to put customer at the center of whatever you do. And it's a journey. It's not like, you know, you master it, but you need to be willing to fail when you learn through it, but you have to continually experiment with it.
Every firm has to look at the technology landscape and say, what is the stuff that we think is going to be interesting to us in 5 years' time? What do we do today that we really should not be doing anymore?
Yeah.
Cloud is a great example of that, where if you're still provisioning bare metal machines inside your own data center, you probably need to think about that. Why are you doing that? Why are you paying people to do that?
Now, the first, you've got to have the right tone at the C-suite and a cultural, you know, organizational shift that says we're going to look at data differently, we're going to look at security differently. Everybody's doing a lot with top line and bottom line revenue right now in AI, but the real innovative ones are doing things with new services to other parties and also helping their customers get value from the data. So I think this all kind of, you know, goes together, and it's really around how do you, you know, continue to evolve and grow and develop value for your customer. And that gets back to having a data and analytics platform that, you know, can really tame the data deluge, democratize insight, and deliver AI at scale. And we just, I think the industry needs to move faster. You know, we've seen some things with DevOps and agile development where we have just lots of different projects going on, and we create, you know, silos of data. So that's kind of an example there where you want to have a higher level vision, but also the ability to move quickly with the right teams to go fast.